Welcome back to IT Free Training. In the last video, I looked at the terminology and concepts you need to understand in order to start using group policy to deploy software. In this video, I will go through all the steps required in order to start deploying, upgrading, and removing software centrally using group policy. To start with, I will first look at how to set up a software share to store the software that will be installed using group policy. When a client attempts to install software using group policy, the client will need to read the install files. When a group policy refresh is performed, the client will perform a test to see how fast the network connection is. If the connection is determined to be a slow link, that is, under 500 kilobits per second by default, group policy will not install any software. If software was installed over a slow link, this would cause significant delays while the user waits for the software to be installed. If you want to change the value used for slow link detection, this can be done from the following group policy location. If you are deploying large software, it is a good idea to configure this value higher than the default. This will prevent software being deployed when the user connects to the office via a slow link, for example, when using a VPN connection. I will now change to my Windows Server 2008 R2 domain controller to have a look at how to set up and configure software deployment using group policy. In order to start deploying software on the network using group policy, you will first need to set up a file share to hold the install files. If I open Windows Explorer and open the folder Software, notice that I have already downloaded two applications and saved them here. These are Adobe Acrobat Reader and Chrome. In order to create a share, I will right-click on the Software folder and select Properties. In the Properties, I will select the Sharing tab and then press the button Advanced Sharing. This will give me some additional options not available when using the basic sharing option. Once I tick the box Share this folder, the folder will be shared. Next, I want to check the permissions by pressing the Permissions button. You will notice that everyone has read access. This is all that is required to install software. Now that the share is set up, I will exit out of here and close Windows Explorer. Next, I will now run Group Policy Management, which I will open from the Start menu. In this case, I want to deploy some software to the users and computers found under the New York OU. To do this, I will expand down until I get to New York and edit the New York policy. In this example, I will deploy Google Chrome to all computers in New York. Since I will be deploying software to computers, I will expand down through Computer Configuration, Policies, and Software Settings, and down to Software Installations. To configure new software for deployment, right-click Software Installation and select the option New Package. The first step is to browse to the location of the install media. I will use double backslash followed by the server, then the share name. This will ensure the clients will be able to find the install media. Once I navigate to the MSI package for Chrome and then select it, I will be given a screen asking the method of deployment. Notice that since this software is being deployed at the computer level, the option to publish is grayed out. If you are not sure which option to select, select the advanced option. Notice that when I select this option, the properties are opened. This will allow you to select any options that you want. You can also change the options later on if required. In some cases, if you select the published or the assigned options from the previous screen, some options in the properties will not be able to be changed later. For this reason, I always select the advanced option and choose which options I want, knowing that I can change them later. If I select the deployment tab, there are some additional options that can be configured. In this case, because the application is being deployed at the computer level, most of the options are grayed out. I do, however, have the option to uninstall this application when it falls out of the scope of management. What this means is that if the group policy is no longer being applied to that computer, for example, if it is deleted or the permissions are changed, the application will then be removed from the computer. You should use this option carefully, as a mistake in group policy configuration will remove the software from all computers it has been installed on. Accidentally removing mission-critical software from your users' computers will not make you very popular in the workplace. Once I exit out of here, that is all that is required for Chrome to be installed on all New York computers. The install will be performed when each computer starts up next. Next, I will expand down through to user configuration and select a new software deployment using the same procedure I used in computer management. In this case, I will deploy Adobe Acrobat Reader, so I will browse to the MSI package for Adobe Acrobat Reader. Once I select the package, I will be asked for the deployment method. Notice that Publish is available since this software is being deployed at the user level. The Published option is not available when deploying software to computers. In this case, I will be using the Published option, but I will select the Advanced option so I can configure all the options later on if I need to. If I select the Deployment tab, notice that the Published option is selected by default. If I select the Modifications tab, this tab will allow me to apply a transform to the MSI package when it is installed. If I selected the option Published from the first prompt rather than Advanced option, this option would not be available from the properties later on. This is just one of the reasons I always select the Advanced option. Once I press Add, I can browse to an MST file that I created for this MSI package. The MST file will configure options in Adobe Reader, such as automatically accepting the license agreement, so a user does not need to. I have finished configuring the group policy object, so I will now close it. To see how group policy deploys software to the client, I will now change to my Windows 8 computer. Since there have been some settings made at the computer level, I will need to first restart the computer. Once the computer has restarted, group policy will be applied from the computer configuration. This will be done before the user is asked to log in. If you deploy software like a service pack, this can greatly increase the startup time of the computer, something to consider before deploying large software like this. Once the computer has restarted and I have logged in, Google Chrome will be installed and is available. The software was installed with no input required from the user. If I now go to the desktop, I can open the control panel by opening Charms, by moving my mouse to the top right, selecting Options, and then selecting the option Control Panel. To see software that has been published on this computer, I will open the option Programs, and then select the option Programs and Features. Software that has been published to the user will not be available until the user chooses to install it. To do this, select the option on the left, Install a program from the network. Notice that Adobe Acrobat is available, and all that is required to install it is to press Install. Once the setup starts, the user only needs to answer the setup questions asked. No administrator credentials are required, and the user does not need to know where the setup media is. Now that we have seen how the software is installed on the client computer, I will now change back to my domain controller to look at the last few options available to software deployment in group policy. To have a look at the options, I will once again open the New York group policy for editing. The options I will look at are the Adobe Reader options found under User Configuration. If I open the properties for Acrobat Reader, notice that if I select the tab Upgrades, I can add upgrade packages. For example, if an update to Adobe Reader was released, I could add it here. When you add an upgrade package in here, you will get the option to either uninstall the old package or leave the old package if the upgrading package upgrades it. If you tick the option Required Upgrade for Existing Packages, this will make sure the upgrade is installed if the previous package was installed. This is a useful feature to select if you deploy an important security update or your company requires that old versions of the software be upgraded. I will now exit out of here, right-click on the package, and select the option All Tasks and then Redeploy Application. This will, as it suggests, reinstall the application. In some cases, you may want to reinstall an application after it was installed. However, in most cases, once the application has been installed, you will not want to redeploy it. The option above this allows you to remove the application. If I select this, notice I will be given two options. The first option uninstalls the application immediately. If you no longer require the application, this is the best option to select. The second option does not remove the application and allows the user to continue to use it. This effectively stops new installs but allows any current installs to be used. This video has looked at how to deploy software using group policy. You can see that by using group policy, you can achieve a lot in the way of software deployment. Group policy provides basic software deployment options. If you want additional options, you should consider a commercial software deployment solution. Thanks for watching this video on group policy software deployment. For more free videos, please see our website or subscribe to us on YouTube. See you next time.